So with n equal to 5, at the end of round 2, every processor has heard from every other processor in the entire system, right? So you can see, eyeball this figure, you can see that every processor has gotten a message from every other processor. And so it's common knowledge that for every processor that everyone else has also arrived at the barrier. So how many rounds does it take to know that everybody has arrived at the barrier? Well, it's ceiling of log n to the base 2. And it's ceiling because it's n need not be a power of 2. So at this point, everybody is awake. So barrier completion here, there is no distinction between arrival and wake up, as you saw in the case of the tree barrier or the MCS barrier or the tournament barrier. In the dissemination barrier, because it is happening by information diffusion, at the end of a ceiling of log n rounds, everybody has heard from everyone else in the entire system. So everyone knows that barrier has been reached. So in other words, in every round of communication in the dissemination barrier, every processor, you eyeball any particular processor, every processor is receiving exactly one message. Exactly one message in every round of this dissemination barrier. And so overall, during the entire dissemination barrier, information diffusion that's going on, every processor is receiving a total of a ceiling of log n to the base 2 messages. Every round, one message, and so there are ceiling of log n rounds, and so ceiling of log n to the base 2 is the number of messages that any given processor is receiving. And once every processor has received this ceiling log n to the base 2 number of messages, it knows that barrier is complete. It can move on. And I've been using the word message in describing this dissemination barrier. It's convenient to use that word because it is information diffusion. But if you think about a shared memory machine, a message is basically a spin location. And once again, because I know an ordained processor is going to talk to me in every round, the spin location for this guy is statically determined. Spin location, statically determined, and so on. So at every round of the tournament, we can statically determine the spin location that a particular processor has to wait on in order to receive a message, which is really a signal from its ordained peer for that particular round of the dissemination barrier. So again, static determination of spin location becomes extremely important if the multiprocessor happens to be an NCC NUMA machine. In that case, what you want to do is to locate the spin location in the memory that is closest to the particular processor. So that becomes more efficient. And as always, in every one of these barrier algorithms, you have to do sense reversal that once this barrier is complete, everybody is going on to the next phase of the computation. And when they go to the next phase of the computation, they have to make sure that the barrier that they arrive is the next barrier. So you need sense reversal that needs to happen at the end of every barrier algorithm. So now let's talk about some of the virtues of the dissemination barrier. The first thing that you'll notice is in the structure, there is no hierarchy. In the tree algorithms, the root of the tree automatically gives you a hierarchy in terms of the organization of the tree. In the dissemination barrier, there's no such thing. And I already mentioned that this algorithm works for both NCC NUMA machine as well as clusters. That's also a good thing. And there is no waiting on anybody else. So every processor is independently making a decision to send a message. As soon as it arrives at the barrier, it's ready to send a message to its peer for that particular round. And of course, every processor can move to the next round only after it has received a corresponding message from its peer for this particular round. So as soon as that happens, it can move on to the next round of the dissemination barrier. And all the processors will realize that the barrier is complete when they've received ceiling log n messages in the entire structure of this algorithm. So if you think about the total amount of communication, because the communication in every round is fixed, it's n messages in every round. And since there are ceiling log n rounds, the communication complexity of this algorithm is order n log n. Compare that to the communication complexity of the tournament or the tree barrier. In both of those cases, the communication complexity was only log n because of the hierarchy. As you go towards the root of the tree, the amount of communication shrinks. So the amount of communication in those algorithms is only order of log n, whereas in this dissemination barrier, since there is no hierarchy, the total amount of communication in the algorithm is order of n log n.